Hi everyone! In the last video, we got our Django app set up, added a model, and added that model to our admin so we could start entering data. In this video, we're going to make it so that we can display the data in our database. Right now, if we go to the root of our site, there's a whole lot of nothing going on. Unlike a CMS, Django doesn't set up anything on the front end when it comes to displaying your data. We have to do that ourselves by writing views, templates, and setting up the routing. You may have heard people talk about MVC, or Model View Controller. That's a way of organizing your code that makes it easier to manage, since each of those three elements has a distinct job. Models, which we did in our last video, describe the shape of our data. Views look at the data we have and decide what to display. For example, do we want to show all of the books or just one? Do we want to show all of the data about a book, or do we want to hide some data or summarize it? Controllers deal with how the data is displayed. For a Django project, templates act as controllers. A quick note, I'm glossing over much of MVC in this video. Check the card for a much more in-depth explanation. With that said, let's get started. We'll be setting up four pages: a static page with no data, a page with all the books, a page with one book, and a page with all of my out-of-print books. To set up a new page, we need to do three things: create a view, create or select a template, and create a route to that page. Let's start with a view. The first view I want to write will simply return a simple HTML page. Open up views.py under the Books app. I'm going to write the view and then go over what I did line by line. First, I made a function called about. Whenever Django calls a view, it's going to pass a request in. This request is going to hold all the data in the HTTP request. This function is going to be our view. We use the render method, imported above, and send back the request, the location of the template, we'll write that in a second, that we want Django to use. Next, we have to make that HTML page. Under the Books app, I create a folder called Templates, and then a folder inside of that called Books. This is where Django is going to look for any templates referenced by the views in this app. In that folder, I'm going to create an HTML file called about.html. Now that we have a view and a template, we need to tell Django when to call that view. Under Better Reads, open up urls.py. First, I import the view. Second, I add a line above the line with admin. URL is a helper function that helps construct URLs in Django. The next item is a regular expression that tells Django what the path to the page should look like. In this case, it's just going to be our root domain and then /about/. After that, we have the view associated with that path. The only thing left to do is to test to see if it worked. In a browser, go to 127.0.0.1:8000/about. If the HTML page loaded, you're good to go. The second view I want to write will return all the books in my database. I'm going to code it up really quick and then go over it line by line. We're going to be using a new method here, all. This method is attached to every Django model you create and will return every instance of that model that has been stored in the database. First, we have to import the book model from models.py. Then, we create a function called getAllBooks, once again passing in a request. The next thing we need to do is get all the books in our database using book.objects.all. Finally, we have to return the request. Like before, we use the render method and send it a template. We'll also be sending a dictionary of values that Django will merge with the template to create the new HTML page to serve. Now we need to create a template for showing all of our books. Since we're passing data into the page, we need to tell Django how to display it. Let's start off by adding a value to our page. When I wrote my view, I returned a dictionary with the key of data and the value of all my books. That means that this page will have access to a value called data. If I put that value in a double set of curly brackets, then that value will be displayed when the page loads. Finally, we need to make the route. In betterread/urls, I need to import the new view. Then I'm going to add a line above about. The route will go to books/all, and the view will be getAllBooks. Let's test the page. As you can see, the data is there, but it's not quite what we want to see, is it? Don't worry about that for now, since we'll be fixing that in the next video. The next view we're going to write displays only one book. Once again, I'm going to write the view and then explain what each line does. This time, I'm going to use a new method, get. The get method returns one and only one object from the database based on a value you send it. The new view is called getOneBook. This time, we're going to send in a request in kwargs, which means keyword arguments. This parameter is going to hold information that's in the path. Next, I'm going to get one book based on its primary key. A primary key, or PK, is a unique integer assigned to every object in a Django database. You will never have two objects of the same type with the same PK. That means it's a perfect match for using with get. If you want to find the PK for an object in your database through the admin, you can find it in the URL. It's the number towards the end. In order to get a book based on its primary key, I use the method book.objects.get and pass in the parameter PK with the value kwargs PK. This may seem a little opaque at the moment, but this will make more sense once we write the route. Finally, I return render with our request, the same template as we used in get all books, and a dictionary where data is paired with our one book. Once again, our final step is to set up the routing. In urls.py, I add a line before book/all. This line looks a bit different from the others because it's going to be more dynamic. We need to get the PK from it, which I'm going to put at the end of the path. Let's go over that part in a bit more depth, since it can be confusing if you're not used to regular expressions. The question mark P means that we have a named pattern. All that means is that we're going to get a value and store it in a named variable. Next, in angle brackets, is the name of the variable. After that, /d means we're looking for digits, and that plus sign means we're looking for at least one digit. This can seem a bit intimidating at first, but I assure you, over time, you'll get more used to it. Now that we have our routing set up, let's go to a page. Go to 127.0.0.1:8000/books/single/1, and you should see one book on that page. Finally, we're going to make a page where we can see a subset of books. In this case, I want to make a page where I can see all the books I own that are out of print. In order to get a subset of objects from the database, I need to use another method, filter. I'll be going over this more in a later video since there's a lot you can do with this method. First, I'm going to create a new view, get out of print books. I'm sending in the request, but not kwargs for this view since I'm not getting any information from the path. Next, I'm going to get all of my out of print books using filter. The filter method accepts what field you want to filter on, so I'm going to send in the parameter in print with the value of false. Like the last view, I'm going to return the request, use the same template as before, and send the out of print books to the template as data. Again, I have to write the route to my new view. I import the view and make the path books/out of print. When I go to 127.0.0.1:8000/books/out of print, I see all of my books that are out of print. Now that I have my view set up, I can go about the work of making the pages much nicer looking. That's going to be next time though, when I go over Django templates. And that's all I have for today. If you have any questions, feel free to hit me up in the comments or track me down on Twitter.